Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Now you have may notice that my last video was only a fortnight ago, whereas I usually upload tri-weekly. This is just me trying out fortnightly uploads as I want to improve my consistency. Anyways, this video is part 2 to my new part 6 series on how each of the 300 largest cities in US got its name. Each video covers 50 cities, and the last video went from Abilene, Texas to Clarksville, Tennessee. This video will pick up from where we left in the previous video, and will cover the cities Clearwater, Florida to Gilbert, Arizona, explaining how each of them received their names. Also, since a few of these cities have duplicate names with the same origin, such as Columbus, Ohio, Columbus, Georgia, Columbia, South Carolina, and Columbia, Missouri, I'll add an additional 3 cities to this list. So this list will cover 53 cities. And before we get into this list, I want to quickly shout out my friend Liam, with his YouTube channel LiamCZ. If you're interested in educational videos covering mainly history, make sure to subscribe to his YouTube channel with notifications on. The link is in the description. Anyways, let's get started with this list. First up, we have Clearwater, Florida. Now, Clearwater is just a translation of the Native American Indian word Pocotopog, which was a word used to describe the plentitude of natural freshwater springs in the area. Next, we have Cleveland, Ohio. The city was named after its founder, Moses Cleveland, who founded the city in 1796. Over the time, the A in Cleveland was dropped because it was believed that it made the name unnecessarily longer, leaving the name Cleveland. Next we have Clovis, California. Clovis was originally just a small railroad town, and in the 1890s, the railroad was extended south from what is now Clovis, California, to around 10 kilometers south. At this location, 10 kilometers south of Clovis, a new railway station, named Clovis Station, was to be built. Surrounding the railway, at that particular spot, was the properties of 2 farmers named Clovis Cole and George Owen. The railroad agreed with the farmers to build a new station on Owen's land. However, the station was named after Clovis, even though it was on Owen's land. The city of Clovis then soon derived its name from Clovis Station. Next we have College Station, Texas. College Station was named after its train station along the Houston and Texas Central Railway, but was also named after the university, for Texas A&M University. Combined, this created the name College Station. Next we have Colorado Springs, Colorado. The city was named to Colorado Springs in 1879 because of the springs found near the Monument Creek, and since it's located in Colorado, it was named Colorado Springs. Next we have Columbia, South Carolina. Columbia was named after Italian explorer Christopher Columbus. Next we have Columbia, Missouri. Now I could not find anything on how Columbia, Missouri got its name, so I'm just going to assume like Columbia, South Carolina was named after Christopher Columbus. Correct me if I'm wrong down in the comments below. Next we have Columbus, Ohio. Now just like the Columbias, it was named after Christopher Columbus. However, Columbus is the masculine version, while Columbia is the feminine version of Columbus. Next we have Columbus, Georgia. Just like Columbus, Ohio, and the Columbias, was named after Christopher Columbus. Next we have Concord, California. The city was named after Concord, Massachusetts, which was named after the Algonquin Indian word Concord, meaning grassy plain, in reference to the landscape of Concord, Massachusetts. Next we have Concord, North Carolina. In the 1700s, in present-day Concord, German settlers had long disagreement with other Scottish-Irish settlers, and eventually the conflict was solved through a compromise. Soon, in 1796, the city was founded and named Concord, which means harmony in English. The city was named this because after the compromise, all the settlers could live together in harmony. Next we have Conroe, Texas. Conroe was named after a Civil War veteran named Isaac Conroe, who lived in Houston after the war and opened a major sawmill in Conroe in the 1880s. Next we have Coral Springs, Florida. Now if you watch part 1 of this series, you will know that Cape Coral, also in Florida, was a planned town built in the early 1960s, and Coral Springs is the exact same thing. The name was just a marketing strategy to make the city sound like a nice place to live in, and there aren't even any springs in the area. However, the name does have some meaning to it. The word coral in the name Coral Springs derives from the name of the company which developed the planned community, named Coral Ridge Properties Incorporated. So the company just decided to name the place after themselves and added springs to make it sound nicer. Next we have Corona, California. The name Corona is a Spanish word meaning crown. The city was named this because of its circular grand boulevard, which encircles the downtown. Since crowns are also round, and the boulevard was seen as grand, Corona was seen as a fitting name, and thus given to the city. Next we have Corpus Christi, Texas. Corpus Christi just means body of Christ in Latin, and the city was named Corpus Christi because it was discovered on the same day as the Feast of Corpus Christi in 1519 by Spanish explorer Alonso Alvarez de Pineda. Next we have Costa Mesa, California. Costa Mesa is a Spanish word meaning coastal tableland, and this is in reference to the geography of the city, right on the shore of the Pacific Ocean, but very flat like a table. And now we enter the D's with Dallas, Texas. While it's not entirely known why the city was named Dallas, it is presumed to be named after the early settler of the city, Joseph Dallas, or former United States Vice President from 1845 to 1849, George Mifflin Dallas. Next we have Dayton, Ohio. Dayton was named after the Revolutionary War general named Jonathan Dayton, who also signed the United States Constitution in 1787, and he owned a large portion of land in what is present-day Dayton, Ohio. Next we have Dearborn, Michigan. Dearborn was named after the Revolutionary War general and former United States Secretary of War, Henry Dearborn. Next we have Denton, Texas. Denton, along with Denton County, was named in honor of lawyer and militiaman John B. Denton, who was killed by American Indians during the Battle of Village Creek in 1841, which occurred in nearby Arlington, Texas. Next we have Denver, Colorado. Denver was named after James W. Denver, who was the former governor of Kansas Territory and served in Congress and the United States Army. When Denver was first founded in 1858, it was in then Kansas Territory, which includes all of modern-day Kansas and parts of eastern Colorado, including Denver. Since James Denver was the governor of the territory, the city of Denver in then Kansas Territory was named after him. Next we have Des Moines, Iowa. Des Moines was named after Fort Des Moines, which was named after the Des Moines River, which is just a French name meaning the monks. The river was named Des Moines by the French because of the Trappist monks that built huts and settlements at the mouth of the Des Moines River. Next we have Detroit, Michigan. Detroit is a French word meaning strait. Since the Detroit River could be seen as a strait, the French named it Le Detroit du Lac Erie, which means the Strait of Lake Erie. In 1701, Detroit was founded on this strait, and it was named to Detroit after the strait. Next we have Downey, California. Downey was named after the former California governor, John Gately Downey, who was the 7th governor of California between the years 1860 and 1862. Next we have Durham, North Carolina. The city was named after Durham Railway Station, which was named after Dr. Bartlett Snipes Durham, who donated 1.6 hectares of land to the North Carolina Railway Company in 1849, so that they could build a new railway station. The station was named after Durham as a sign of their gratitude for Durham's donation. Next we have East Los Angeles, California. Extremely self-explanatory, it's located just east of downtown LA. Now if you want to find out how Los Angeles got its name, then subscribe to my channel with notifications on, because I will be going over that in a future episode. Next we have Edinburgh, Texas. Edinburgh was named after the hometown of a very prominent businessman living in that area, named John Young, who was born in Edinburgh, Scotland. Next we have El Paso, Texas. El Paso received its name from the Spanish phrase El Paso del Norte, which means the pass of the north, as it was seen as a doorway to the United States. Next we have Elgin, Illinois. In 1835, the city was founded by two European brothers named Hezekiah and James Gifford. They decided to name the city after the hymn, the Song of Elgin. Next we have Elizabeth, New Jersey. The city was named after Elizabeth Carteret, the wife of one of the two original proprietors in New Jersey, George Carteret. Next we have Elk Grove, California. In 1850, a man living in present-day Elk Grove named James Watson Hall built and opened the first hotel in the city, which he called Elk Grove. Since this was the first hotel in the city, it was decided that the city would be named after it. Next we have Enterprise Nevada. Now I could not find exactly why, or even anything saying why, but apparently it sounded like a good name, so the founders of the city named it that. Next we have Escondido, California. Escondido simply means hidden in Spanish, and the city was named this because the city is somewhat hidden in a valley surrounded by mountains and foothills. Next we have Eugene, Oregon. Eugene was named after its founder, Eugene Skinner, who founded the city in 1846. Next we have Evansville, Indiana. Evansville was named after Colonel Robert Evans, who was promoted to Brigadier General during the War of 1812, which was the same year Evansville was founded, by a man named Hugh McGarry Jr. 2 years later in 1814, McGarry named his village to Evansville, after Evans. Next we have Everett, Washington. Now the origin of this name is actually quite funny. In 1890, a group of New York-based businessmen, including Everett Colby, who was the son of one businessman named Charles Colby, were having dinner together in Colby's home. They were discussing creating a new industrial town close to the Puget Sound in Washington. Everett asked a businessman named Henry Hewitt for more dessert, and Hewitt laughed. "That's it, we should name our city after Everett. This boy only wants the best, and so do we." And with that, their new city was named Everett. Next, we're entering cities beginning with F, with Fairfield, California. Fairfield was founded by a man named Robert H. Waterman, who named a new city after his hometown of Fairfield, Connecticut. And Fairfield, Connecticut got its name from the large open fields that were in the area. Next we have Fargo, North Dakota. Just like Billings, Montana, this city was originally a railroad town built by the Northern Pacific Railroad. The city was named after William G. Fargo, who was a director for the railroad company. Next we have Fayetteville, North Carolina. Fayetteville was named in 1783 by the North Carolina General Assembly after a French nobleman named Marquis de Lafayette, who had aided American troops during the Revolutionary War. As a sign of appreciation, the decision was made to name the town of Fayetteville after him. Next we have Fontana, California. The name Fontana is an Italian word meaning water source or fountain, and the city was named to this because it is located in close proximity to the Santa Ana River. Next we have Fort Collins, Colorado. Fort Collins was first founded in 1864 as a military fort, and it was named Cape Collins. However, as the fort grew, it eventually turned into a large town, and then a city was named after the fort. The fort itself was named after Lieutenant Colonel William O. Collins, who ordered the establishment of Camp Collins in 1864. Next we have Fort Lauderdale, Florida. The city was named after a series of forts constructed during the Second Seminole War in 1838. Led by Major William Lauderdale, him and a large group of soldiers traveled down to the eastern shores of Florida. In order to capture land and fend off American Indians, Lauderdale and the soldiers constructed three different forts, with one being named Fort Lauderdale. Later in 1911, the city of Fort Lauderdale was incorporated, and it was chosen to be named after the fort. Next we have Fort Myers, also in Florida. Just like Fort Lauderdale, the city was named after a fort built during the Seminole Wars. During the Second Seminole War, in 1841, a fort built by Army officer Abraham C. Myers was built to be used against the Seminoles. At the end of the war, the fort was abandoned, and a few decades later in 1885, the area became the city of Fort Myers, which was named after the fort. Next we have Fort Wayne, Indiana. The city of Fort Wayne was named after Fort Wayne, which was named after General Anthony Wayne, who established a fort at the confluence of St. Mary, St. Joseph, and the Maumee Rivers. Next we have Fort Worth, Texas. Fort Worth was originally a military fort along the Trinity River, built to protect settlers from the Native Americans. The fort was named after its founder, William Jenkins Worth, who was a Mexican-American war veteran and founded Fort Worth in 1849. Next we have Fremont, California. Fremont was named after a general named John C. Fremont, who was one of the leaders of the conquest of California and a former U.S. senator and California military governor. Next we have Fresno, California. name Fresno is a Spanish word which simply just means ash tree, and the city was named this because of the ash trees that lined the nearby San Joaquin River. Next we have Frisco, Texas. Now the city of Frisco was originally supposed to be named Emerson, but that name was declined by the US Postal Service because of another town in Texas also named Emerson. And not knowing what else to name it, the residents decided to name it after the St. Louis-San Francisco Railway and named the town Frisco, which is short for San Francisco. Next we have Fullerton, California. Fullerton was founded in 1887 as a railway town for the California Central Railroad, and they needed new land to build the town on, so they hired the president of the Pacific Land and Improvement Corporation, George Fullerton, to construct a town for them. Because of his efforts, the new town was named after him. Next we have Gainesville, Florida. The city was simply named after General Edmund Pendleton Gaines, who was a commander during the War of 1812. Next we have Garden Grove, California. Garden Grove was given the name by its founder Alonzo Cook in 1874 after he purchased a large 80 hectare piece of land in the area. Cook decided that he should turn the land into a town, so he donated some of his land to build a school and post office, and since Cook wanted to create a nice town, he named it Garden Grove, which is a nice name. A lot of people opposed this name, so Cook responded by saying, "Well, we'll make it appropriate by planting trees and making it beautiful. And I must say, it does look quite nice today." Next we have Garland, Texas. In 1887, the city of Garland was founded, and it was named after the at the time US Attorney General, Augustus Garland. And finally, we have Gilbert, Arizona. Gilbert was originally just a railway siding along the Arizona Eastern Railway, and the siding was built on land donated to the railway by a man named William Gilbert. Over time, the area around the siding grew into a town, and then into a city, and since all cities need a name, it was decided that the city was to be named after Gilbert because of his kind donation to the railway. And we're done. That was how each US city got its name, part 2. Turn on notifications and subscribe if you want to see the other 4 parts of the series, and thank you for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe, and feel free to click on one of the videos on screen. Thanks for watching.